Hello, people of the interwebs. I have not been here for a very long time. It's been like a month. So yeah, because I went back to school, you know, school started again. I just had to get all my stuff together. But today I'm going to be creating this eye look for you guys. And it's just kind of like a really nice, kind of like a soft, but yeah, bold out there. Kind of, you can kind of appropriately wear this to like school, work, or anything. Like on date night for Valentine's Day. So yeah, so I already did this side of the eye. I just done my eye makeup, and you guys can, ghetto hair. It's because we are in the ghetto, okay? So, let's begin. So first I'm using the Color Institute palette. And it comes with like this little thingy down here, which you can pull out. Well, I don't think you can pull it out, but I did. Okay, bring you guys closer. And so I just pulled this out. And I was using pretty much all these shades and one shade in there. And yeah, so I'm just going to take my finger in here. And I've actually already put this kind of like white cream up in here, up on my eyelid. And I'm just going to grab this C brush from, it's an e.l.f. Professional Eyeshadow Brush. You guys can't even see, I don't know why I'm doing that. And then I'm just going to apply that all over the lid. And I'm just going to use my Color Institute for it. Oh, dear godness. Okay. Okay, let's move on. I'm going to apply this to the lid and all the way up to the brow bone because it's going to be your highlight. And of course, you can use any white color or shadow base that you want. What's up, guys? And I'm just going to apply that all over to the lid, including the inner corners, up into the brow bone. Now, the eye I'm doing right now, I find this the hardest eye to do because, you know, I like doing this because, you know, my arm's just right here on my hand. I can just, you know, little this arm. I can't just take my left hand and start doing makeup because that's just be kind of weird. I don't know, actually. I just think it would be kind of weird because I'm not left-handed. But my friend, she's both left-handed and right-handed, and she is lucky. Oh, dear. So, look at my eye. So, I'm just going to blend that. I'm going to bring this up. Just going to blend that. And then I'm going to take the second palette, which is this really pretty lilac-y lavender color. And yeah. And I'm just going to be doing eye makeup in this video for now. I'm doing this part one of my Valentine's Day series. So yay! Okay. You guys did not need to see that. I'm just going to apply this all over to the lid. And just up to the crease a little and into the inner eye corner. Just a little bit more. That looks good. And then I'm going to be taking another e.l.f. Professional Eyeshadow Brush. Which one? Okay, I was using this one. It's just not really, it's kind of like, you can see the difference in the length. So it's more of a C brush. And this is their C brush, I think. This is more of like a, I don't know. It's a good brush. And I'm just going to take this color. Oh. I'm so weird. I'm going to take this color right here. My phone, I swear I have a BlackBerry, and I swear nobody has BlackBerry anymore. So if you guys hear that sound, it's the foreign BlackBerry. So I'm just going to take this nice kind of like next color. It's a bit warmer. I'm just going to apply that to the crease. And then I'm just going to grab my blending brush, which is actually a paintbrush, but it's clean. Don't worry, guys. Apply more and take more of that color. Just tap off the excess and just blend and apply to the crease. And you want just kind of like windshield wiper motions. I'm just going to do that. And this is your basically going to be your pinks. Without, you just want to use like pinks or mauves or purples to create that, you know, create that really nice pink color. Because if you use like a pure pink, like maybe like this one, and oops, right here, it might give you like more of like a, pink eye look, especially if you have like blue eyes, it'll really give you a pink eye look. So no, I don't want you guys walking around pink eye looking eyes. Unless you have pink eye, then you have pink eye looking eye, but you know what I mean. So I'm just gonna apply it to the crease. And I don't have any face makeup on because I'm just going to apply that a little later, because this eyeshadow I'm using actually does have a lot of fallout. And yeah, so So just by that same crease, you can see that adds some definition and color. And I'm going to take this kind of like, I'm going to take this really pretty kind of like a brick red color. And it's on the pinkier side, so I think they put it in this little thing, I guess. Why else, right? Apply that onto the same blending brush and just apply that to the crease again to add some definition and a little bit more color. So you gotta see this eye's just a little, I think this eye is a little bit darker. So, and then just gonna take more, a little bit more of this. Blendy. And then I'm gonna take this other brush. Actually, I don't know why I still have it. It kind of bends up and down. I'm just gonna make it taller. And take this really pretty, like, kind of like cranberry wine color. And this bit kind of mute it out. Because the other one kind of creamy looking. So, yeah. If you guys know what I mean, tap off the X. I'm just gonna apply that to the outer V. And kind of halfway into the lid, just add some color and a little bit more depth because it's the darkest color in this little palette thing. You can use, like, if you have this, you know, go ahead and use it. Of course, you can make the exact same look as I do, but if you don't, just use color similar to this, and yeah, apply that to the outer V. And then I'm just going to grab my blending brush again. I'm just gonna blend. Pretty! I'm gonna take this little color right here, the one right up here. I'm just gonna take it onto my finger and just kind of pat it onto the lid. Makes a little bit more brighter on the lid color, so that means that you can take a little bit more of this color, your darkest color, and just apply it more to the crease to make it a little bit more pretty. And you know, we can go all iridescent, like, you know, it works out well. Pretty, I like it. Of course I like it. Why else am I doing this tutorial? I'm gonna take my Essence eyeliner brush. I'm just gonna take this really pretty deep wine, almost brown color down here. Take a hit pan on it. No, it's just a speck of white eyeshadow. If I hit pen on, I think I cracked my favorite eyeshadow. I'm just going to tap off the excess. And then you're just going to line your eyes with it, which is really pretty. This is the easiest way to start using eyeliner, you know, with a pencil because you have more control over it. And then with eyeshadow, and then you can kind of move on to gel, then pencil, and then look, you know, just all the eyeshadow, all the beautiful eyeliners of the world. So I'm just going to line this. You guys can't see me because when I eyeline my eyes, it's not pretty at all. So. You're gonna want to stay relatively close to the lash line and kind of wing it out a bit. And grab some more. Awkward silence. Yeah. So I just lined it, and to make it more deep, I just have water in this cup over here. I'm just going to dip my finger in it. And then I'm just going to grab more of the eyeshadow into the brush and just kind of pat my finger in it. And so I just make it a lot more stronger color. Like when you take anything, any eyeshadow or anything to color, it makes it a lot stronger and stay longer. So I'm just going to do that. You guys hear, oh my goodness me, do you guys like hear people? Because I live in an apartment building and there are people out there that always fight, and it's kind of scary. I'm gonna apply a little bit more to darken it up. Oh my gosh, you guys, I went to my drugstore today and I saw these two ladies that work in the makeup department setting up new CoverGirl stuff for spring 2014. Cannot wait. I'm just gonna take whatever I'm just gonna take whatever is left on my brush, put along the lower lash line. You can apply more mask, like, you know, eyeliner and stuff, but I'm pretty happy with this. Because, of course, you can always make makeup your own. I'm just going to take this mini thing I have. I'm trying to use up my mini mascaras, and this is actually probably my favorite mascara I've ever had. I kind of like the Benefit Their Real mascara, but this one's kind of my more favorite. So, this is the Fresh Supernova mascara. It's just a mini. And I'm just going to apply that. And it makes your lashes look really natural. And preference, like, you know, like, I prefer to have natural lashes kind of more when I'm wearing, like, strong makeup like this. And more of, like, when I'm wearing more of, like a champagne color that isn't as noticeable with, like, you know, Benefits Their Real. Because it's kind of, whoop. Yeah, make them look really nice and big. Well, I like this mascara. I'm gonna do this. Comment down below if you guys, like, you know, use, like, open your mouth and you put on mascara. Check the mirror. Okay. And I'm not gonna put anything on the lower lash line just because I don't like mascara on my lower lashes. See kind of difference mascara makes, and this is just the black color. I think you can buy this at Sephora. I'm not sure though. I know I got my mini at Sephora, but it came with like this little mini face wash that they sell there, so I'm not sure. You might have to ask or order from the Fresh website. And this is a really nice lengthening mascara. Makes your eyelashes look natural. Oh dear goodness me. Mascara. What have you done? Yeah, so makes your lashes kind of like big but natural, but you know, beautiful. So next, I'm just going to take, I already have a little concealer on because I was at school this morning, but we had a half day. Woot woot. So I had a little bit of concealer on for school because whoopsies, you know. I'm just going to take some a little bit more. I'm just going to apply that. This is my Rimmel Match Perfection in the color Ivory. I think they changed up the packaging and the name. So I think this one, which is Ivory, would probably be called Light. You know, so I think, and it's a highlight concealer, but I'm pale altogether, so everything needs to be concealed under my eyes. And not my nose and all that. So I'm gonna blend. And tip with liquid concealers or any concealer in general, unless it's like you just pat or brush in. But I like to pat my under eye concealer. And use your ring finger because it's your softest finger and it's your gentlest finger. Because I know I tried to see if that was true. I can hold open a door with every finger. It's even my pinky except for my ring finger. So if you guys know why the ring finger is your most gentlest finger, please tell me. I would really like to know. I'm just gonna draw my nose. And I usually just kind of use my Real Techniques brush everywhere else around my face, but I don't know. I think when you have more like eye makeup on, then your fingers are just well for blending out your stuff to make it look a little bit more natural. Your face stuck with something wrong with me. Okay, so then I'm just gonna take my Rimmel they should make a Wake Me Up powder. I think Elle Mae does actually. I think I've always wanted to try. This is my Rimmel C Matte Powder in 011 Creamy Natural. And I'm just going to take my Equals 2 Fluffy Total Face Brush and just going to swirl that around and just dab it under my eyes first to keep it from, keep my concealer from creasing. And I'm just going to take the rest and apply it to my T-zone. I'm just going to take some and just going to sweep it all around the face. Because I like a matte face, but with a little bit more oily. A bit of dewy finish around my like temples, I guess, and like around my cheekbones. And yeah. And then I'll be right back. You guys, I forgot my blush brush. Oh my god, I forgot my blush brush. I'm back. Record timing. So then, I'm just going to take my blue, and this is from the Rexall brand. I don't think they sell these anymore. From Canada. I think they're a Skit brand now. And just fix up my camera. And this is the NYC Bronzer. It's an angled blush brush, but I like using it for bronzer because I don't really wear blush because I have kind of like red cheeks all together. So I'm just going to take, this is in Sunny. I'm going to take some onto my brush, tap some off. It's really pigmented. I'm just going to suck in my cheeks, and yeah. And some light bronzing. But if you have more of a neutral eye, then do some more heavy bronzing. But not when you have a really, you know, heavy eye. And I'm just going to take my Eco Tools brush again. This is nice and fluffy. It blends out stuff really well with my bronzer. That looks a bit darker to me, so I'm just gonna take my, where's my blendy brush. Actually, I'm just gonna take this brush and apply a bit more of this darker color, the eyeshadow. This is the thing, if your eyeshadow doesn't look like even, you just want to make it more even. Apply that to the eye. Okay, my tutorials are really long all the time, so I don't know why. So yeah, then I'm just going to take my Lily Cole from the Body Shop Peach kind of corally blush. One swipe, and my cheeks are kind of, I wish you would not, but it's for you guys who want to wear blush, wear a cream blush. It's kind of lasts longer, and it makes you look like you're glowing from the inside. So I'm going to take my powder and just kind of, whatever's left on the brush, set that up. And then, I'm going to fix up the brows. And then, I'm going to just take my Soap and Glory, a Great Kisser Moisturizer in Juicy Peach. And it smells and tastes so good, you guys. I'm not even joking. Smell. It's actually just a really sheer color. Wet it to the lips. To prep them for the lip gloss slash things. Yeah. And I'm just going to take my Color Institute palette again. I actually just have this angled thing that brush that came, angled eyeliner brush that came from a, or eyeshadow brush that came in the set. But I like using it as a lip brush. I'm just going to take the pink brighter side of my makeup. Because there's this really nice kind of neutrally pink up here. And I'm just going to grab it. Not grab it, but you know what I mean. Onto my lip brush. And I'm just going to apply that. See, it's really pigmented, which I really like. Because these are like glossy lipsticks. You can just leave it like that, which I like. But you know, I love me my red lip no matter what kind of eyes I'm wearing. So I'm just going to take this really nice red color right here. It's kind of like your perfect red. I'm just going to apply that over top. And because you have the muted, you have the like kind of Barbie pink or light pink underneath, it's going to kind of mute out the red. Apply some more. And that's it. That's gonna be a makeup look for my Valentine's Day part one makeup. And I hope you guys really liked it. You know, I know my videos are long. I'll try to learn how to edit, but I can't make any guarantees, you know. So I hope you guys liked it. Here it is. And yeah, stay tuned for my hair tutorial. Bye, guys.